Coming up on Daytime, toss those oversized books. We'll show you how to jazz up your coffee table.
I've incorporated fresh flowers, a little platform, which you buy a piece of wood, spray paint it, and suddenly you've got new dimensions.
I've got a question for you.
Okay.
What is on your coffee tabletop right now? And there's a specific reason why I'm asking you.
Drinks. No, I'm kidding. our house has sort of a coastal beachy vibe. So on my coffee table, which is like a nice woven table, I have a little tray with a shell border and some nice books and a little starfish that I found.
Interesting. Wow. A coffee table is an important focal point in any room, obviously.
That's right. And today we've got Karen Post from Home Frosting to share some trends and tips to achieve your perfectly designed decor statement.
And it sounds like, Karen, Lisa's coffee table looks very much like our first
I love that. I feel proud. Well, I tapped the designers at Home Frosting to do their tabletop, and I'm going to share with you how they did it, how they can do it at home, ideas and inspiration.
Why is it important to have kind of a good-looking tabletop?
Well, your tabletop is a focal point in the room. It ties everything decor-wise you've got going on. It also has some function. If you've got remote controls, and you're expressing yourself, and you can have pieces from your history, from your travel, so there's lots of good reasons why you want the perfect tabletop.
Well, let's start with this one, Karen. This looks like Lisa Daly's tabletop at home.
A little bit,
yeah. There you go. So what is special about this one?
So here we have a rustic table, and also consider what's on the floor, the rug, and then elements of design. I always say simplicity is best, never more than 4 to 7 groupings of things because you want it clean. So here we've taken succulents, which is a great solution that low maintenance.
Yes. That's what I need. If you don't have to water them, that's good for me.
Yeah, and this designer loves coastal, so she's got her flamingo, her scented candle, which the light is great, and then a stack of books, some elements. It's just a beautifully designed tabletop.
And you can't really see them all that well, but there are coasters on that tray, which I think is a key element to have on any coffee table, because people should not put a drink right on a particularly a wooden coffee table.
Absolutely, and it's another opportunity to reinforce your story, which is the coastal look.
Yeah, the woven look.
Now,
yeah.
Where do you hide the remotes in that? Just in the couch cushions, or?
Well, this one we don't have a container. You could certainly add a container, swap out one of those things. Mm-hmm. But this household, I'm sure they're in the cushions.
Now, this one has a container, and this is yours.
This one is mine.
And you love your velvet. Karen.
I love my velvet. Sophisticated, elegant. Again, make sure you've got different dimensions, not everything the same. Here, I've incorporated fresh flowers, a little platform, which you buy a piece of wood, spray paint it, and suddenly you've got new dimensions, some green glass, the spears. I love elephants, very in right now. And then my little box.
See that?
Look at whatever that. I want to keep in here.
Well, obviously, there's money in here.
That's right.
Because you're not letting anybody in.
That's a great
place for my moms. I love this idea.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Really excellent.
Yeah, and ottomans are an awesome coffee table. Mm-hmm. I always put a piece of glass on it just so it's secure and everything's
keeps it flat. Beautiful, and I love all the gold tones that are back with the hunter green. It's like the 80s are back.
It is
I'm
a little
you,
bit.
All over again.
Well, I love the way that you have designed, because it's more challenging, I think, to design the top of a round table, because you never know, like, okay, which angle do I, is it for everyone or just the one direction? So I think it's lovely. You sort of have, interest in every direction.
Well, just rule of thumb, keep it simple, different dimensions, and you can change your tabletop with seasons, with holidays, or just because you feel like it.
That's
right.
Collection.
Right,
okay, and you've got some nice coffee table books over here.
Absolutely.
And tell us about this one,
Karen. All right, so this look is a nostalgic glam, and the story behind here, so Lindsay, our designer that put this one together, incorporated the big playing cards. So moving away from watching TV all the time, it allows you to interact with your guest or your family. I love those.
Kind of like parlor games.
Yeah, absolutely. And the skull head is her college mascot. Again, we've got the fresh floral and the little topiary books are amazing. If you don't have the right books, get old books and cover them with wrapping paper, with fabric, or remove the cover and use the leather bind to add to your color theme.
Right.
But and the geometric rug, I love that.
Beautiful.
Beautiful. Honestly, you gave us all a lot of great ideas here. And the takeaway here is really what? Keep it simple.
Keep it
make
simple.
Make it functional.
And if you have pets, keep them in mind. Wagging tails can be an instant accident. And in my household,
pets.
If anything looks like a toy, look out because it may be missing. Have fun. Express yourself.
All right. Well, Karen Post, thank you so much for Home Frosting. Really appreciate all your good tips.
My pleasure.
All right. We'll be right back with more Daytime after this.
Okay.